Coming up on Sports Weekly, the San Gorgonio baseball team battled Jurupa Hills for first place in the San Andreas League. Plus, Arroyo Valley took on Rim of the World at San Manuel Stadium, and the 66ers are back in town. We've got details on San Bernardino Strong Night at the 66ers game on Friday. That's coming up on Sports Weekly. Despite having just one senior on the team, that's Jason Wright, the Spartans are poised to win another SAL title. But the other Spartans in the San Andreas, the Jurupa Hills Spartans, have jumped out to the league lead. No surprise that Jurupa Hills and San Gorgonio are once again in the mix for that league title. Jurupa Hills threatening early in this one against Bill Ettinger and his squad. But a nice play coming up by Sanji shortstop Jason Wright to snag the line drive. But Jurupa Hills back for more in the second. The wild pitch off the backstop, and San Gorgonio able to get the out at the plate. That saves a run for Sanji. Later, it's another wild pitch, and this time San Gorgonio gets the runner at third. So a couple outs the hard way for Sanji. Matt Vigil on the bump for Jurupa Hills, and the big southpaw made it very difficult for San Gorgonio batters, the big righty, I should say. Meanwhile, Jurupa Hills trying to move runners around off the bunt. San Gorgonio with the force out at third, but now it's Vigil at the plate. And doing damage with a bat, Vigil slaps the single to right. Diego Armas slides home. Jurupa Hills goes on top one zip thanks to the RBI single from Vigil. Gavin Dorn follows that up with this nice base knock to left field. Coming up, in comes Daniel Rojas, and just like that, it's 2-0 Jurupa Hills. San Gorgonio gets one back here, but Jurupa Hills goes on to win 5-1 the final score. So Jurupa Hills sits in first place in the San Andreas League. Now let's roll to San Manuel Stadium for another edition of the County Clash. Arroyo Valley taking on Rim of the World in San Andreas League play. No score when Alex Villavazo smacks the sack fly to the left field. Robert Blackman tags up from third, darts home to give Arroyo Valley the 2-0 lead. Scots pitcher Kyle Llewellyn works out of the jam with a big strikeout. And now it's Rim of the World's turn to try and push a run across the plate. But the Hawks turn the old 4-6-3 double play to get out of the jam. Rim of the World hurler Llewellyn would settle in and keep it rolling at San Manuel Stadium. The strikeout there. The Hawks would tack on to the lead when Blackman slaps his double down the right field line. Justin Serena scores, making it 3-0 Arroyo Valley. The Hawks add to their lead as Carlos Hermosillo drills the offering to left. That brings home Blackman 4-0 Arroyo Valley. The Scots were down, but they were not out. Cody O'Kelly now at the plate for the Scots. Laces the base hit to left field. Nick Crisp scores, and Rim of the World is on the board against the Hawks. O'Kelly would come home on this sack fly to left from Deegan Risness. The Scots make it a 4-2 ball game on that play. So let's fast forward to the top of the fifth inning. Base is loaded, and O'Kelly strikes again. O'Kelly triples the left field, and that will clear the bases. Rim of the World takes the lead 5-4, and that would be the final. The Scots rally for a one-run win at San Manuel Stadium. Well, the County Clash will make way for the Inland Empire 66ers home opener at San Manuel Stadium on Thursday, April 14th. The 66ers are once again affiliated with the Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim. The players' journey began here at Diablo Stadium in Arizona, but now that spring training is over, it's on to San Manuel Stadium for another season of 66ers baseball. The season opener is Thursday, April 14th versus the San Jose Giants. But mark your calendars for Friday night, the 15th, for San Bernardino Strong Night at San Manuel Stadium, including special jerseys for the players and hats for the fans.
Yeah. So Friday night, we're going to be doing our San Bernardino Strong Night. In my opinion, I think it's going to be one of our best nights of the year. Really, obviously, after the December 2nd incident, as a team, as an organization, we thought that we had to do something for the community. Immediately after the event, we had the vigil here at the stadium, and you know, after talking about that, we decided that, you know, during a game we wanted to do something as well. And so Friday we'll be wearing special jerseys to honor the families and the victims of December 2nd, as well as doing a ticket fundraiser. We have some raffles, some different stuff going on. Should be a great night for the community, and we're really excited for it.
Still to come on Sports Weekly, San Bernardino took on rival Pacific on the baseball and the softball diamonds. Plus, Cajon visited Citrus Valley for first place in the Citrus Belt League softball standings. That's coming up on Sports Weekly. Well, that will do it for this episode of Sports Weekly on IEMG. You can watch all the segments from this show on the IE Media Group YouTube channel. Feel free to share those segments from this show and all the past shows as well. And while you're there, be sure to hit that subscribe button. I'm Pep Fernandez. We'll see you next time on Sports Weekly on IEMG.